相変わらずトラブルに巻き込まれる体質だな、キリトは。
エギル、聞いてたのか。
ここは俺の店だぞ。
しかし面白い情報だな。ホローエリアか。隠しエリアとかそういうところには大抵お宝がごっそり眠っているもんだ。
もしそうならアインクラッドの攻略も少しは楽になるかもな。
もう何人かは向こうに行ってるんだろ。だったら俺たちも負けてられないぜ。
俺も早く行きたいところなんだけど。
なんだよ、だらしねえな。
で、ああ、さっき済ませた。
だったら何人か集めて早速乗り込んでみるか。
気をつけろよ。俺が行った時はいきなりスカルリーパーが出たからな。ステータスはだいぶ弱くなっていたから二人で仕留められたけど、強敵だぞ。
おいおい、マジか。まあ今日のところはちょっと覗くだけにしておくわ。
ああ、マップデータもないし、じっくり攻略した方がいいだろうからな。
あ、それじゃあ行ってくる。
気をつけてな。アスナたちはどうしたんだ。
ああ、部屋にいるんじゃないか。
キリト、アスナはだいぶお前のこと心配していたぞ。もちろんキリトが悪いわけじゃないが、今日くらいは一緒にいてやった方がいいんじゃないか。
まあそうだな。
おいキリト。
なんだクライン、早いな。
早いなじゃねえっての。ホローエリアなんて転送先存在しねえぞ。
ん、何言ってるんだクライン。俺はアクティベートした後確かに確認して。
疑うんだったら一緒に来い。
おいクライン、引っ張るなよ。
こりゃもう一波乱あるかもな。
ホローエリア管理区、間違ってないよな。
ああ、ちゃんと合ってる。
転移、ホローエリア管理区。
本当だ、おかしいな。
だろ？キリトがいい加減なこと言うとは思わないけどよ。
クライン、ちょっとどいてくれ。
テイン、ホローエリア管理区。
来られたぞ。フィリアはいないのか。どこかを、しかし、どうしてクラインは。もしかして、この文様と関係がある。とにかく戻ろう。ちゃんと言って来られたぞ。
ああ、そうみたいだな。
俺にもわからない。ちょっといろいろ試してみよう。
帰ったか、遅かったな。
ああ、いろいろと試してきた。
キリト以外のプレイヤーはホローエリアに転移できない。
そして一緒に行けるのは一人だけ。
一人だけか、厳しいな。それで満足に戦えるのか。
向こうで知り合った女の子はソロでもなんとかなってるから、無理ってことはなさそうだ。
でもよ、これは公開できないな。
ああ、無用の混乱を招くだけだろ。
くぅ、せっかくお宝が目の前にあるってのによ。おい霧の字、 向こうへ行くときは俺のことも誘えよな。
あ、なあ、努力するよ。
キリトにそんな余裕があるか、怪しいもんだ。あれだけの女の子を相手にするんだぞ。
いつもこいつばっかり。
向こうで何か分かったらクライにも教えるから。
絶対だぞ、男の約束だからな、キリト。
Welcome back, my vassals. I'm doing this here because I need to make sure I mark this part as episode 2 of Let's Play Sword Art Online Remake Hollow Fragment. Okay, while you're in the Hollow World, or the Hollow area, people have actually been sending you messages, but we're not gonna get those just yet. Also, I'm going to tell you what this is about later. Just make sure we remember Floor 76, Zephyr Way, during the daytime. We also need to remember the name of Kokoa. For those of you wondering, Zephyr Way is actually right outside of Floor 76's gate. So, there's Leafa. She's in this game. There's Asuna. She's also in this game. And here's me. I'm gonna go up to my room really quick, just to show you guys something. And yes, I do need to make markers, because I'm actually making this one big recording. And it's actually gonna be a full 3 episodes, one of which is only gonna be on the Tyranno 840 channel page. So, yay, my channel gets an update. But there will be 2 episodes up on the Death Knight Corporation main page, along with hopefully the Akiba's Trip re-edit will be up. But at any point that you feel that it is necessary, you can return to the title, which will automatically save the game and put you back on the title screen. Go figure. And you can change your avatar at any point in time. And you might see in a couple of episodes, like a lot of episodes from now, I might actually start changing around some of these numbers. But as for now, it's only going to be the Tyrant of Chaos playing. But you might see some changes. But the main reason I wanted this all to be one recording, but this is going to be episode 2. There's still not going to be a whole lot of gameplay. But I really need to split the episodes up a little bit. So here is where episode 2 starts, right at that conversation with Agil. Or Agil. I can't remember off the top of my head. But as soon as you go out this door, there is another cutscene. And as soon as you start wandering around town, there are more cutscenes. So before that, there were a couple of things I wanted to go over. First off, implementation. I didn't get to go over in the first episode because I got cut off. Implementation is this menu here. I think it's actually bigger than it was on the PS Vita. Probably not. But basically, you have to do these implementations. But fair warning, all of these suck. Whenever you complete an implementation, like I'm gonna set this one to start now because this is the easiest one, you just gotta complete a mission. When I complete my first hollow mission while this is being checked, it will allow me to go back to the observatory, and I will be able to use the element implementation system to open this menu, which you can see a little plus to the left. Once this is done, I will be able to open that menu and have multiple different things to implement. And that's where the game gets really complicated. Also, we have a hollow map. It is much, much more beautiful than the Vita version. But if you want like a full detailed explanation, or a much more detailed explanation than I plan to give, go check out Havian's video on the PS4 version of RE Hollow Fragment. But Yeah. Anything in purple is a place that we can teleport to. That means that there is a teleport stone there. And all of the landmarks are here so that we can actually see where we're going outside the world. And this big dot is the observatory. My favorite area for grinding is actually this area that you see around the observatory. It is full of mostly level 115 to level 130 enemies and above. So don't go there until you know what you're doing. Can't open that yet. I already went over that. Oh, and our messages are here. Okay. So, Klein's talking about the nightmare scenario. Now we gotta make sure that we get to the 100th floor. That's actually... Most of these characters are so far just gonna be talking about infinity moments. And Xenon's having trouble sending her messages. Leafa's talking about how it's nice to be with her brother again. Elizabeth, I believe, is talking about new materials and opening a shop. Silica talking about how she wants to work with us, and Asuna's just happy that we're not dead. I have my full load of items because, like I said, this is a playthrough that I've already been through. If we go up here to the stairs, I can actually show you a lot more. As soon as the game finishes saving and loading. We can go right in here and, yeah, this is the inventory. This is everything that I have saved over here. If you find stone or ore, you might want to just save it. Be careful how much you're saving because you don't want to throw any of it away. It sells pretty well as well. But, yeah. Anything else I needed to go over? At least right now. Let's see, skills. Oh yeah, I'll show the skills this. Mine is at the completed version, I've been grinding for a long time, okay? That's the best way to put it. I grinded for days to get some of these skills. Each one of these 1000% that you see took me an entire day to do from 600%. It usually takes about a day's worth of about 5 hours worth of effort to get from about 200% to 1000%. So that's like 5 hours of your life you just gotta set aside and fight enemies that are slightly stronger than you. Which, as I stated before, right here below the observatory, there's an area with some level 101 enemies. And they're very good for grinding for sword skill points because they don't attack very often. Also, you'll notice in the top right corner that I am saving up some skill points for later. And I picked up Katana Mastery and I came all the way down here. I've even maxed out the katanas. And I've maxed out two-handed swords. I won't be using too much of two-handed swords because they are overpowered. Or they were in the beta version. I might test them out to see if they're still overpowered. But I was working on spears and I believe daggers last time I left off. But each of these has a different passive ability that goes with it. Like, you get plus 10% attack speed. That makes it so that your auto attacks hit a lot faster. Here we got 10% defense. 10 evasion. Plus 10% experience. Survival, which gives you that plus 200 point regen. Which is really good because, well, in a dungeon it does take a while to regenerate health. So I like to use the survival skills a lot. But once you pick up one of the regeneration abilities, I'm not sure which one it is I use all the time. But once you pick it up, you won't really need this so much. So I'm gonna move it over later. But you'll probably see me walking around with the one-handed sword. You might even see me walking around with a scimitar every now and again, because the scimitars are really cool and they're very easy to come by. And you'll almost certainly see me wielding katanas at one point in the game. And like I said, I want to go over two-handed swords to see if they're still as overpowered as they were in the Vita version. And seeing as I am already almost to 800%, I might as well complete the spears. And maybe the rapiers if I'm... I'm probably not going to do the rapiers for a while. But, oh yeah, and I'll show off some equipment that I've got. I just want to give you guys something to, other than, what this is going to ultimately devolve into. And, before I had, this undercover agent coat, I was wearing this dual vest. Because I found it in the hollow area in a really high level dungeon. So, I mean, it was already overpowered, but it's still not at the level of a boss creature. Even though, the undercover agent coat really isn't all that great. And, you get the black leather right at the beginning of the game. You can't sell it as far as I know. And here's the original black coat, which is, nothing compared to the undercover agent coat. And, then we got the Vanguard mail, which makes you look like an NPC. Which you can top it all off with the Vanguard Greaves, and now you really look like you're just an NPC. But I've got all sorts of cool things that I just didn't really feel like getting rid of. Got those black leather boots, the Chaos Greaves, which are really cool. I was basically running around in this setup for a while. But, what else? Oh yeah, I was running around in the Gladiator at the beginning of the game. The Gladiator equipment is something you should definitely pick up at the beginning of the game if you don't already have a save file. Then we got the Chevalier, which really isn't all that good. The Berserker, which is, basically one step up from the Gladiator, or it might be the other way around. It's the other way around. So pick up the Berserker equipment, and then go hunt down the Gladiator equipment. Then we got the Snowflake, which is just gonna make you look like an NPC. And I mean, you see what I mean about the NPCs just by looking around at these guys? That guy looked derpy. But, I like how each of the NPCs is just a little bit unique compared to all the other ones. So you don't really feel like everybody is just the same person. Everybody has their own unique taste. Alright. Now I gotta check how much time I've spent recording, just so I don't go overboard. I'm at an hour and 40 minutes, so... Alright. At any point in time, you can just walk over, talk to somebody, and form a party. And I'll be going over more of that later. But right now, I just want to get a couple of story elements out of the way. Also, now that I'm right here where nobody's talking yet, I want to apologize. I left my TV up too loud. So, I don't know if there was any echo because I've got my headphones turned down a little bit. But, I'm gonna hope there isn't. But there probably is. So pardon me. This game is very loud.
Ah, 気づかれちゃったか。こんにちは。
今までに会ったことはないよな。
うん、はじめましてだよ。私はストレア。よろしくね。どうしたの？怖い顔して。ちょっと興味があったから。キリトは強くて有名人だもん。興味を持って当然。あ、わかる？私も結構強いよ。それにしても、キリト、やっぱり近くで見た方がずっと可愛いね。
Just go ahead and let this sink in. Straya is my least favorite character in this game. She is also my least favorite character to party with because she uses a two-handed sword, and as I stated before, they are overpowered.
いいじゃん。だって可愛いんだもん。こうしたくなっちゃうよ。
And that's not the only reason. We'll get into character suicide later, but as for now, just take in the fact that I am now being raped by a character that I don't even like.
Ah, ne ne, これから時間ある？一緒にお茶でも飲みたいな。
And let me pardon, not pardon, let me apologize for making a joke about rape.I do it all the time, so, please don't sue me.
いいよね。さっきも要望を聞くって言ってたし。やったね。ここのカフェでいいよね。さ、座ろ座ろ。ねえキリト、そのカフェオレって美味しい？私のミルクティーちょっとあげるから、そっちも飲ませて。思ってたより甘くて美味しい。コーヒーとかってだいたい苦いじゃない？苦いのって嫌いなのよね。本当？それじゃあいただきます。そうだな、75層のボスを倒した時とか。それって、私のことをもっと知りたいってこと？キリトって、結構積極的なんだね。でも質問はここまで。答えてほしければ、また今度デートしようよ。今日はありがとう、キリト。またこ… 遅かったじゃない。もう早くこっちに来て。
何もないけど、
ただキリトに会いたかっただけ。早く早くこっち。
で、あの人は
何と言われても。
アスナさんも知らないんですか？
うん、キリト君と一緒にいるところは見たことがあるけど。
NPC じゃないよね、あれは。下の階層から新しく来たとか、そういう。
それにしては随分仲がいいみたいですけど。うわっ、あの人キリト君の膝の上に座った。ちょっとちょっと、何なのよ一体。
何かとっても仲良しさんみたいね。
アスナ落ち着いて、顔が全然笑ってないわよ。
私ちょっと行ってきます。あれはもう放置していいレベルじゃないですよ。
なんだ、俺の膝なら漏れなく全員座れますよ。
あんたは観葉植物の植木鉢でものっけてなさいよ。
ひってえ、ちょっとした冗談じゃねえか。
それじゃどういったことなのか、キリトに説明してもらいに行きましょうか。キリト、ちょっといい？
皆さんどうも。
キリト君、あの、あなたはキリトさんとどういう関係なんですか？
キリトとはとっても仲良しな関係。
仲良しな関係だったら膝の上に乗ってもいいんですか？
You know, this could all be fixed if we just say that she was our stalker.
なるほど。紹介ありがとうね、キリト。それとキリト君、後で私の部屋に来てもらえるかな？ねえねえ、私も行っていいかな？アスナってキリトのお嫁さんなんでしょ？キリトのお話聞きたいな。なんか楽しそう。
楽しそうって。
ねえ、みんなで行こうよ。
え、そりゃ構わないけど。
なんなんですか一体。
そういえば私まだキリトの部屋に行ったことない。
アスナの部屋もキリトの部屋も見てみたいな。
なんだか大変そうね。
あの、じゃあ部屋に来る？
あ、でも今日はやめておく。もう十分に楽しんだし、それにみんなとも仲良しになれたし、だから二人の部屋に行くのはまた今度の楽しみにとっておくね。
ええ、あなたがそれでいいならいいけど。
うん、それじゃあ私帰るね。キリト、
はあ、嵐のような子ね。
何だったの本当。どうせキリトが街でナンパしたんでしょ。ちゃんと責任取りなさいよ。
Now they're giving us a tutorial on how to open up messages and how to navigate town. But, I have, believe we've got something else we gotta do. Yeah. Open up the menu. Open up. What? Where do I? There it is. Each section of the touchpad opens up a different part. If you just swipe down, it'll open up the big menu, but you can open up the sub menu with apparently the top left. So, what? Oh yeah, this. I believe I need to speak to Asuna right now. Go to the administration area. Speak to Philia in the administration area. Clear the 76th floor. There's a rumor of a beautiful... Okay, no. But there is a couple of things I want to take care of. And a couple of things I want to look at. Hello, Yui. Now, she should be around here somewhere. Maybe not. Also, I'm loving the 60 frames per second thing, but it is a lot faster than I'm used to. I'm still only used to games that run at about 30.
Kirito-kun.
And, the PS Vita version only runs at 30, so I'm used to it taking, like, forever to get through this area. Time for a cutscene.
ああ、75層の扉が開いてから攻略組が帰ってこないだろ。これは何かあったなと思ったわけだよ。キーボーがなかなか一人にならないから会うのが遅くなっちゃったよ。まあそうだけどな。ああ、戻れないんだろ？なに、もともとこの世界から抜け出せないのは変わらない。だったら、俺っちも前に進むよ。そうだろ？これは、マップデータだよな。あり…借りができるのはあんまり良くないんだけどな。どく。そっか。じゃあこれからもよろしくな。言われなくても大丈夫だよ。
Yeah, if you need to repeat any tutorial, hold on. Okay, if you need to repeat any tutorials, talk to Argo. She knows everything.Except how to fight. Oh. And that was Lisbeth sending us a message saying that she opened a shop in the merchant district. And it's pretty simple. Well, actually, it's really complicated.If you've read the Sword Art Online books, the way that the smithy works in this game will make no sense. But, it makes it more simple for the game, but it doesn't follow the way that Sword Art Online is supposed to be run. Because you're supposed to be able to upgrade more than one stat at a time, but you, with Lisbeth Smith Shop, you can actually only upgrade one thing at a time.Unless, of course, that is fixed at a later point, but...
Yo!
I'm gonna do what I do in any MMO right now, and I'm going to accept every quest they have. I do this in every MMO I've ever played, meaning Terra. And, yeah, it usually works out pretty well.It's the reason that in Terra, I was the mass murdering, or the mass murderous, farmer killer. I killed lots of farmers. Of every race. Just running around as Rico Mine, and I just went around killing farmers because there's something wrong with farmers. Why do you still have something above your head? You don't have any more quests.
Yo.
Wow. Oh, right, because I started over, so I've got a bunch of these already finished. I want to go over these first, so let me go over them really quick. Quests in MMOs are pretty basic, pretty simple and easy to understand. Let's see, we've got a girl's wish and a weapon made of stingers that we're done with already, because I've killed a lot of bees over the years. I think I believe the game came out last year. The girl's grandma's not feeling well. If she had some medicinal herbs, she might be able to make her some medicine. Well, three valley herbs doesn't take long to get. However, the antidote crystal I don't need, and the experience is so minuscule, it's not worth it. But, like I said, this is just something I like to take care of. And the bee stingers. What do I need to do for this? Oh yeah, I've got to kill enemies on. So I'm just going to turn these in really quick. Nothing all that amazing. Get some antidote crystals, get a little bit of money. And some boss information. Turn in the quest. Get a strength potion, some money, some experience. Oh, and that's something I didn't go over. But if you go into guild, you'll notice that there is a spot marked enemy details and checklist. Everything on the checklist, I don't believe you need to do anything on the checklist, but you need to fill out the enemy details. To fill out enemy details, you just have to make it to the end of this floor's dungeon. To fill out the checklist, just do whatever it says. Like right now, we need to slay the named monster Crimson Spinner, which is actually right in front of the dungeon, so I'm gonna do that anyway. Or it might actually be the one in the forest. I'll kill both of them, just to be safe. I don't know when I don't know which quest it was that... It was the one for the girl, but a girl's wish gave us some quest information on our checklist, but apparently we've already done something else. Wait.
Nani?
I want to check out Sinon really quick, and... And, I do totally mean that in whatever way it can't just pop in your head.
Nani? Do.
And because I am best of friends with Sinon, I literally have it maxed out because I've been sleeping with her, like, 5 or 6 times already. If I can remember what her armor is... I can't remember. I believe that's Asuna.
Arigato.
Oh no, I'll just try everything, see what happens. Nope, that wasn't it. Okay, what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna change the view really quick, because this is a fun thing you can do.
Nani?
And, we're gonna try something else. Duel, black leather. Are my DLCs just not active or something? Because, I mean, I had, Sinon wearing DLC armor, so it's completely possible. Yeah, I don't have her DLC armor anymore. That's sad.
Kirito.
Oh well. I have something just as good. Right, the circle button. I have underwear for Sinon.
Do.
And while it's technically more than underwear, it's mostly just like half a coat. So if I go over to character information and I go into... No?
What?
Xenon? How do I do it again? Return your gear to default.
Okatawa. Tanamu wa ne.
Nani? Okay, character information. Okay.
Nani?
Why can't I do it? I went through all of them.
Nani?
I know for a fact I maxed out Xenon's affection, and I've maxed out all three of her stats. So, maybe I can't do it yet? I don't know. How about... Okay, I've still got things I apparently have to do. I'm guessing that go to the hollow area or something. Maybe I have another cutscene that I need to activate somewhere. But I really want to change Xenon's clothes back to what I'm used to. I had her wearing her Gun Gale Online armor. And I don't have it anymore.
<笑>立派な店構えだな。リゼ。<笑>そうでしょ。真相回転。リズベットブグ店へようこそ。滑り出しにしてはまあまあね。 いい感じの店でしょ。ちょうどこの物件が残っていたのよ。前みたいな水車がないのは残念だけどね。思えば、あのお店でキリトの片手用直剣を作ったっけ。結局、あれより強い剣は作れなかったわ。ダークリパルサー。暗闇を払うもの、だった。
他の子に言ったらアスナに怒られるわよ。私が作ってあげてもいいんだけど、ただし私のスキル上げに付き合ってほしいのよ。ほら、事件のせいで鍛冶の上級スキルがなくなっちゃったって言ったじゃない。だからまた上げ直さなきゃいけないのよ。それがないと 鍛冶としても半人前だし、それにキリトの剣も作れない。ごめん、キリト攻略もあるし忙しいかなって思ってたから。
Okay. No, I'll save it for later.
来てもらえたら、その時スキル上げに付き合ってもらうから。
無理して来なくてもいいからね。うん、待ってるからね。
Okay, I'll mention it now.
Yes.
I don't like Lisbeth. I mean, I love a good blacksmith. I mean, I married Elena when I was playing Rune Factory. But I don't like Lisbeth. I don't know why. She is a good character and she's written pretty well. I just don't like her. So, there's nothing wrong with her.It's just, I don't.
Nani?
So, do I have the option now? No. No, I don't. And there's your item shop, and you'll actually... Here, I'll show you what I mean. These are the prices of items in this world. What's this do? Okay. Yeah, items in this world are expensive.Also, you can buy food in this world, too. And the food does nothing more than, increases affection with certain characters. I swear, I had everything for Xenon. So, maybe there's something I gotta do first.Just gonna skip this tutorial. I can explain pretty much everything it can. And honestly, that tutorial was just explaining the rules of Sword Art Online. You've seen the show, you know exactly what that tutorial just said. Okay, that's nice. She still has her bow. That's gonna be interesting. And I already went over that. Oh, so, to get that bottom one, I had to make sure that our point value was at least what it said. So, the fact that we are way over that kind of just gave that to us.But, you'll see over there, there's some, orange exclamation points. That one was for earlier. We have a message that we can read from Kokoa. And, this is exactly where we are. We're currently on the 76th floor in Zephyr Way in the middle of the day. What is this gonna say? It's just a thank you letter.Why am I bathing for you? It's gonna make me do it all over again, isn't it? I don't want to do it all over again. I really don't. It took forever to get all that armor.That was one of the reasons why I wanted to make sure my save file was over here. Wait, did it do that for everybody? Let's go look at Silica. I know that I got some of Silica's armor. And I usually left her in it as well.
Yoshi!
Yeah, Silica's in her, specialty. So, let me switch. Okay, if I go to Silica and I say that I want character information.
どうしました？
Is it maybe just not an option I have yet?
どうしました?
Because that's not the armor that Silica normally wears, so I know that she's not, that she has more than what she's currently showing. Okay.I'm just gonna dissolve the party here. Oh yeah, I will show off Elizabeth's armor shop really quick. Or, what? Smith. Oh yeah, it's right here. This is what I said I was gonna do.Listen, I can go over it a lot faster than you can. Basically, you go into enhance, you pick the sword you're planning to use, we'll go with this, currently, let's see, can't remember what it is.Strength plus 40, but it's losing something. Is it the acceleration? Yeah, it looks like the acceleration keeps it normal. But you'll notice that the acceleration has a 20% success rate. That 20% success rate is because this is going to be the fourth upgrade. And when I made the upgrades earlier, I was at whatever the normal percentage is times 2. So normally I would have been at 40%.But as the game will tell you, the most important stats are... Oh crap, they changed it. I believe it's going to be... not strength, vitality, maybe dexterity and agility. I remember that it was agility and hit in the other version, but I don't know what they replaced hit with.Oh well. But I mean, that's how it works. You'll mostly only be using that. And if you can forge something, then you're lucky. But forging doesn't really help you because she'll usually end up forging you something from a long time ago.
いらっしゃい!
Gonna have to deal with what I got for now. Wait, hold on. I think I saw something. No, I didn't. And I still haven't figured out what this is for. I know that something's gonna happen with it later.But I think that's going to be it, because I've gone over most of what I can think of right now. Oh, yep. Havian was right. There's the lag. I'm starting to see the lag. We're still above 30 frames per second, though.I guess I'll just have to see if something changes later. So, Xenon, why don't you have your GGO clothes anymore? I miss those. They look really good on you. And they also showed less of your underwear than your ultimate clothes do, but...that will be it for now. next time. Maybe we'll play some game. Maybe we'll actually start playing Sword Art Online. And I'm now navigating through the oops. Okay, I didn't do anything wrong. I'm navigating through the capture device now, so I've got lag. But until episode 3, all of you, my exploding penguin vassals, should get back to work. Enjoy the title screen for the next couple of seconds.